Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about how we can send data from Google Sheets to HTML body in Google Apps Script. So in this video, we are going to put 800, this number 800 in an email, which is in a HTML format in Google Apps Script. So I'll just show you what I mean. So for example, if I have B3 cell with 800 value in it, I'll click on send email, and if I go to my Gmail account inbox and if I check the email, this 800 unit email will be sent to my inbox. This is the 800 units every day, right? And if I go and select this cell and convert it to 1200, and if I click on send email, then again if I go to the inbox, this 800 will be converted to 1200. So that means we can send data from Google Sheets to our email body, and that email body is written in an HTML template. So let's begin. So in this, what we have to do is we'll go to extension tab in our sheet and click on app script. In this case, I have already written the code, so I'm going to explain you the code, how it works, and what are the connections we require to connect our HTML code with our Google Apps Script code. So when you will open this page, you will get this code.gs file in here, right? And not this template.html. So in code.gs, we'll create a function. This is the function. Function name is sendData. And these two brackets, then I'll put curly brackets here like this. And after this, the first variable is SS equals to spreadsheet app. Spreadsheet app is basically used to call the Google sheet, right? So I'll write spreadsheet app dot open the sheet by URL. URL will be this Google Sheets URL. I'll just copy this and we'll paste it in between these two double quotes. Okay, so this variable contains the Google Sheet URL, right? So now I know that I got the Google Sheet. Now I want the tab which we are going to work on. So I'll create a tab variable here. Then I'll put ss.getSheetByName. Sheet by name means get the tab by name. Tab is data. As you can see in this, the tab name is data. I'll go back to the code. So I've written data here. Now we got the sheet, we got the tab. Now if I go and check the cell reference, that's 1200. The cell is B3, right? So basically I want this 1200 to be pulled from this sheet and to be sent in HTML code. So I'll go back to app script and I'll create a new variable units count, and then I'll call tab.getRange, and I know that cell value is B3, hence I have written B3 in double quotes dot get value. So that means in this line, whenever this code runs, right, this particular variable will contain 1200 in it. Okay, so with the help of these three lines, we have pulled the data 1200 into this variable, and we are ready to use it in our further code. So basically, before going further, we have to create an HTML page here. So how to create an HTML page in this? So in this, we have a plus sign here. I'll click on this plus sign and we'll click on HTML. So as soon as I click on HTML, it will create a new file. You can name it anything, right? I'll just click enter. And here it is. So by default, you will get a outer structure of the HTML page, and you have to enter the body in between these two body tags, right? So in this template also, you can see that this and this are the outer structure, and my email structure is in between these two body tags. So for this video, I'll just delete this, okay, and we'll explain you the template part. Okay, so my mail is hi all. I have created each line in div container like this. This is very important when you are creating an HTML page, right? So I'm writing hi all, and again I'm creating a div container in which I'm writing we got a new supplier which can provide, there is something here you can just ignore for now. Okay, we'll just skip this part. So we got a new supplier which can provide dash units every day. Request your team to please contact the supplier and proceed with the others, and container close. And then I have used this. This will basically enter two lines in between, and with a gap I am writing regards and then name, and both are in div containers. So this is a very simple format, HTML format, in which I want to send the emails. So as you can see in the email also, we have the email like this: hi all, a new line, and then some space in between, then regards and then name, right? So this is my email template. Now this particular code, okay, this particular code does not know that there is a file called template.html in this. So that means we have to create a bridge between this sheet, this code.gs, and template.html. So how we are going to do that? We are going to do that with the help of HTML service. So I've created a variable temp in which I've called HTML service.createTemplateFromFile. And which file? The file name is template. So this line, Google Apps Script understands that this is an HTML request, and we are asking Google Apps Script to create an output, to create a template with the help of this HTML file. So that means a link has been created. Now this code knows that there is a HTML file named template.html. Now, very important step, this line basically, you can say this line is basically called in this page. So what we are doing, we have called the service, okay, and we have stored that service in temp. So that's why we are writing temp dot units count equals to units count. You can name this temp dot unit count, instead of unit count you can name A, B, C and whatever, okay, it does not matter. I usually keep it same just to make sure that right data is going into right HTML line. So basically when the HTML code is huge, then there is a very high chances that there is confusion between the variables, which data is going in which line. So that's why I just mentioned unit counts as it is, equals to unit counts. And this unit count on the right hand side is this. So basically currently there is 1200 in the cell. In B3 cell there is 1200, okay, you can understand instead of this you can write just 1200. This is same as this. So this, that means whatever value is present in B3 cell, that value will be stored in units count, and this units count will be called here. So that means temp.units equals to units, and this is a nomenclature through which we can transfer this 1200 to the HTML page. How we are going to do it? We'll go to template. Okay. Now I want to enter that units count here. So that's why I am writing less than question mark exclamation equals to. This is a standard format. Okay. Whenever you are calling, you have to write this. After that, you will call the variable. Then question mark and greater than sign. So if I write ABC here, then I will call ABC here instead of unit counts. So make sure that this, any text after this dot, right, this will be basically identified in this template. So in this, I'll just convert it back to units count. Okay, now we know that we have connected the service with HTML page, and with the help of this line we have called that 1200 number in this particular line in between in this. So this particular text will get replaced with 1200 whenever this code will run. Cool. So we know that we have replaced the number, we have the HTML file with us. Now time to close this HTML service and evaluate and get the content from this HTML service and store it in a variable. So that's why we are writing variable email body equals to temp. This temp is this HTML service dot evaluate. It will evaluate everything dot get content. Okay, this 1200 will be saved and then evaluated, and then complete content will be saved in the email body. Now our 90% of work is done. Now the only part is remaining is to send the email. So we'll use mail app dot send email, in which I'll put these two brackets, round brackets, then curly brackets like this, and then I'll write to colon to which email ID I want to send, then this comma, then again subject, place the subject line, then comma, HTML body colon email body. Email body is this. So this complete get content data, right, that will be saved in email body, and this email body will be served as an HTML body. So that's why this sending email with the help of this type of format, the email will be in a well formatted manner as you have created in the HTML code. Once you are done with this, you can go here and you just create a button here. I have already made a video on it, how to attach a script to a button. You can watch that video. I'll just attach this script with this button and it is done. So if I go and change it to 50 and if I go and click on send email, it should convert the 1200 number into 50 and it will trigger an email to my inbox saying 50 units every day. This video is created to make you understand the concept that how we can pull data from Google Sheets, from Google Apps Script, and enter that particular value from that sheet into an HTML template and send it across over email. I hope you like my video. Let me know in the comment section which all topics you want to cover. I'll definitely create a video over it and post it on my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.